Hi, everyone. Thank you for joining me. I'm glad you're all here, and Happy New Year's to everybody. I certainly hope that the new year will be much better than this year in 2020. Recently, there was two earthquakes down there by Southern California, San Diego, Oceanside. The first one being a magnitude 3.0 and a 2.6. It occurred at 1:33 a.m. local time, and 25 people, according to USGS, said they felt this earthquake. Not a big deal, but I was inspired to look into this more. These two earthquakes are along the Elsinore Fault Zone, which is an extension, part of the San Andreas Fault Zone, which leads me into another report, which leads me into all the earthquakes that have been occurring that I reported earlier down there in the Gulf of California. What caught my eye in this report from 2008 was the name of Lucy Jones, who works for the USGS at that time in Pasadena office. They found that the San Andreas Fault could start breaking at its southern end near Bombay Beach. So much tectonic energy is currently stored in this section of the fault that once the rupture starts, it might not stop for more than 2 minutes. 2 minutes of shaking back and forth of probably at least 6 feet. 6 feet of shaking every second. When the rupture finally stops, the ground in the immediate vicinity of a 120-mile-long stretch of the San Andreas Fault will have shifted more than 44 feet. The strong shaking associated with the seismic wave of this 7.8 magnitude earthquake will have done more than just rattle the 22 million people living in the region. Countless houses, overpasses, and dams will have been badly damaged or destroyed. Power and water will be out for weeks. Now, when they wrote this paper back in 2008, their estimates gave it 30 years. Within 30 years, they were 100% sure that a large magnitude 7.8 or greater earthquake would happen. Within 30 years. That was 12 years ago. So that would cut it down to within 18 years. Within that time frame, there will be a large earthquake in this location. Here is the scenario map that they put out November 13th, 2008. So in my last report about all these earthquakes that were occurring in the Gulf of California and how that tension was going to be applied going north, I wondered about all these recent earthquakes along the San Andreas Fault Zones, the adjoining fault zones, this one here being the Elsinore Fault Zone. It actually came in as a magnitude, let me show you, 3.44, not a 3.0. Yeah, I wanted to look at the size of the earthquake because I figured for 25 people that late at night, I was surprised there was that many that felt it, bothered to report it. All the way to Thousand Oaks and Santa Clarita. For some reason, USGS doesn't report all the earthquakes down there in the Gulf of California, but this is all the 2.5s within the last day. And if we go to all earthquakes within 1 day, we got a new one right here, which is a 0.5 for Anza, California. And then if we go to the last 7 days, there you go. You can see the earthquakes along the Elsinore Fault and the San Jacinto Fault. But if we go down to the Gulf of California, they only have one earthquake reported. That was a magnitude 4.7 on the 26th. The seismological station for Mexico only lists them going back for 3 days. Here we have a magnitude 3.4. That was today. We also have a 3.6. That was yesterday. A 3.7 yesterday. A 3.0 yesterday. A 3.5 today. And a 3.3 yesterday. So that was for 2 days. Now this is for 3 days, the last 3 days. Okay, a 3.7. 3.8 on the 29th. That one I did not report. A 3.5 on the 29th. Let's see, we got more up over here. A 3.4 on the 29th. And a 3.4 on the 29th. Here is the monitor. I'll show you where it's at in a minute. But it's for the El Sonora fault zones. You can see them all marked in red. Lots of them here. This is what it was showing when I pulled the files. USGS has 42 earthquakes listed on this map right here. A lot of earthquakes right here. 27. Now this is near the Palomar Observatory. That is this monitor right here. 27 earthquakes along this fault zone, which is part of the San Andreas fault zone. That is a lot of earthquakes, which shows tension has built. So the largest being the magnitude 3.0, which actually is a 3.44. We got a 1.3, a 2.6. These are shallow. 3.1 kilometers in depth. So that would be 1.9 miles, almost 2 miles in depth. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. Yeah, 27 earthquakes. Once again, this is part of the San Andreas Fault Zone. It's an extension. You see, we got a locked, blocked area here. That's probably why so much tension has built up, preventing the movement of the tectonic plates. I'm going to bring this out. Look at some of these historical earthquakes. San Jacinto, 1918, a 6.7. Further north, where it joins up with the Whittier tongue tide, sorry. 1987, a 6.1, 1994, yeah, right there, that was the 6.7 North Ridge earthquake. That was so devastating. So let's go from there, and we'll bring it down. We got the Newport Inglewood Fault. Yeah, we got the San Andreas Fault. These are all extensions, part of the San Andreas Fault. So over here we got the Elsinore Fault. Let's follow it up. The Whittier Fault. And it goes all the way up. Yep. To the North Ridge earthquake. So recapping, we'll come all the way down. Follow it down, down, down. To the Salton Sea. Where Lucy Jones says it's got 18 years. For a major earthquake. And we'll come back down, down, down to the Gulf of California for all those earthquakes that USGS has not reported. And I told you, stress and tension was moving north. I hope you're prepared for a large earthquake. Can you imagine a 7.8, as Lucy Jones said they know is coming? Can you manage without power and water for weeks? No sanitation? Can you imagine the riots, the fires that would break out, people that would be going wherever they can to find food and water? Listening to the police scanner for the fires down there by Boulder, Colorado. The Costco building. in the mall there that burned. There was reports of people in the building, what was left of the building, with flashlights, getting what they could. They have now asked for extra police to cut off access to the burned out areas because so many people are trying to get in after they were evacuated. And that's an area where over 600 homes were destroyed. Can you imagine how many homes and businesses would be destroyed from an earthquake this size that they are expecting? So when they say that this area is past due for a major earthquake, they are not joking. If it happens in the winter, are you able to keep yourself and your children warm? If it happens in the summer, are you able to keep your family cool, provide them with decent food to eat, able to cook it, keep it refrigerated? So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. I do hope this coming year will be much better than the last two. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.